Hello guys and welcome back once again to the channel and welcome back to the full reaction and review of this amazing El Clasico that we had just witnessed. And what a game of football we had. Just like its name, it was a pure El Clasico. There were goals, drama, hunger, everything you need to make the game amazing, it was present there. Both teams showed an amazing performance, but eventually it was Real Madrid who get the job done in an extra time. But also on the other hand, Barca also showed an amazing fight back performance. It was disappointment, of course, we didn't get the result that we wanted. But still, this is only the beginning. Our squad is finally taking shape and from here, we will only grow. Well now, initially, if you look at the lineups from the both sides, Barca quite surprisingly put Ferran Torres directly into playing 11. He played his first match as in Clasico. He played on that right wing with Luke De Jong in center and Dembele on that left wing. And in midfield, we had Gavi, Busquets and Frankie De Jong and our back four was Pique, Araujo, Jordi Alba and Dani Alves. And on the other side, Real Madrid just had one big change, which was of David Alaba was dropped out and Nacho was brought in. Well now talking about the first half, honestly Real looked much better side than Barcelona. They looked controlling the game and tempo from their midfield and also they were finding Vinicius who was brilliant in this match. And on the other hand, where Barca were playing with that high defensive line, which I really liked the most, that they were fearless in this match. Xavi placed his setup was quite a risky one because throughout the whole game, of course, we were maintaining that high defensive line in order to put pressure on Real Madrid. But still, having Vinicius and Benzema, it was risky because any small mistake in the midfield would lead to Real's counter-attack. And well, that's how basically Real scored their first goal. Benzema caught Busquets in the midfield and won the position from him and then released Vinicius with a pinpoint pass down that left flank. Vinicius used his pace and showed his composure and finished the chance that he got. And throughout the whole game, Benzema and Vinicius, this duo were really creating a lot of problems for us. And well, now talking about Barca's backline and especially that right side who had Dani Alves as a right back,
who mostly played as a wide centre back in this match to be honest,
to mark Vinicius and his runs. And well, of course, in terms of sprints, Vinicius was obviously had an upper hand, but still, Dani Alves was quite good whenever he had to defend the ball from Vinicius. He used his experience and made quite few good challenges. So Dani Alves playing as a wide winger, our shape mostly looked like 3-5-2 or in 3-4-3 formation. But well, after this first goal from Real Madrid, Barcelona were quick to react. They started getting possession back, which really helped them to build up the plays from the back. And again, one of the most significant thing which I saw about Xavi's setup today was like we literally saw what his idea and tactics were about. After getting possession back, Barca tried to stretch the game. Our attack mostly came from that left side where Dembele was constant threat and honestly he had an incredible game. He was really looking sharp and was looking good in those 1v1 positions and also he was cutting inside on his right foot to take those shots. And also, he was creating spaces basically for midfielders to make those run in the box by stretching the Real Madrid's defense line. And off the ball, Real Madrid were set up in compact 4-5-1 formation. So of course, to stretch the game, Barca tried playing diagonal balls to the wings, mostly on that left wing, where Alba started overlapping occasionally and with Dembele attracting defenders to create spaces for the midfielders to make those forward runs. And of course, our equalizer had to come from that left flank. It was decent cross from Dani Alves which was won by Frankie De Jong who was running into the box and ultimately it lays off for Dembele and from there Dembele brilliantly puts a low cross where Militao's clearance hits off Luke De Jong who finds the net and well, he has scored his third goal of this year and also he has scored in El Clasico and again, he did the job of what strikers gotta do to sniff around for the ball in the box. And now moving on to the second half, we made a couple of changes over there. We brought back Abde on place of Ferran Torres and most importantly, Pedri who was came on the place of Frankie De Jong and suddenly Barca started looking a whole different team. Pedri's influence made us to control more of the game in the final third and also with him, we were started looking far more better than Real Madrid. But still, Real Madrid is a kind of team which doesn't mind if they don't have possession. They will simply try to win the ball and would try to find Vinicius or Benzema who from there would try to start a counter-attack. And well, basically, the second goal was came in from of their left side where Mendy got passed easily to Dani Alves and put a cross in for Benzema, which was initially saved by Ter Stegen, but Carvajal regained the rebound and put a low cross for Benzema and from there Benzema finished the chance and again Madrid got into the lead. But still, Xavi this time had enough quality on the bench. So he called Ansu Fati and Memphis Depay, where Memphis Depay played as number 10 with Ansu as a striker. And well, all these players who came back after injury were performing as they never had left this pitch. Their intensity, their hunger, this was really making the game very interesting. And well, the major reinforcement we had in the attack was of course of Ansu Fati, who required just 8 minutes to be on the pitch to score his comeback goal and a crucial equalizer for Barcelona. Across from Jordi Alba, when Ansu lips on it and heads it into the bottom corner and made his comeback with a goal in straight in El Clasico. And with this goal, we managed to force the game into extra time. And again in extra time, we looked quite well, we had our chances, but again, we got caught on counter-attack, where Jordi Alba didn't get a challenge right on Casemiro. Casemiro then releases Rodrigo down that right side, who sends a cut back in middle where Valverde gets into it and seals the victory for Real Madrid. And well, that was quite a story for whole game, where Barca dominated position, had chances, but again, we didn't make the most out of them. Where on the other side, Real Madrid, whenever they got the chance, they capitalized on them. And yeah, eventually, they got the job done. But still, this defeat for Barcelona was not the discouraging one. The players got up whenever they trailed behind. They showed that true character and most importantly, they played to win here, not to avoid defeat. Xavi had a clear game plan for this match. We were clearless and that's why in the second half, we were looking more threatening side in terms of attack. And also, another boost was to see Ansu and Pedri getting back on the pitch and who showed their class as generally they do. And so now finally, Xavi getting all his important players back on the pitch. From now on, we might see a better and stable Barcelona from here, as Xavi would have all his important players by his side and would look to get back in the form to grab that Champions League spot in La Liga. And of course, the another aim would be to win that Europa League. So that's it for today guys. Do let me know your thoughts on this game, which was nothing short of entertainment. So don't let me know it all in the comments down below. And as usual, I'll meet you soon with another new video. Until that time, Urka Barça!